This is Jazz at Lincoln Center's Let Freedom Swing. My name is Jake Blasini. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. We are so excited to present this concert, From Spirituals to Swing. We're going to be playing songs of love, songs of hope, encouragement, uplift, unity. And with that, we're going to start right there. Take it away.
Stealing down to my shoes while I sit and sigh for my blues. Always get that mood indigo since my baby said goodbye. In the evening when lights are low, I'm so lonesome I could cry. 'Cause there's nobody who cares about me. I'm just a lonely soul who's bluer than blue. When I get that mood indigo, I could lay me down and die. Always get that mood indigo since my baby said goodbye. In the evening when lights are low, I'm so lonesome I can cry. 'Cause there's nobody who cares about me. I'm just a lonely soul who's bluer than blue can be. When I get that mood indigo, I could lay me down and cry.
Make some noise, make some noise. Over there, that is Brianna Thomas on vocals, everybody. Right next to her, Bruce Harris on trumpet. Alphonso Horne on trumpet. Gabrielle Murphy on alto saxophone. Corbin Jones on baritone saxophone. Back here on the drums, Norman Edwards. Next to him, Mr. Bill Crow. And last but not least, on guitar, Justin Poindexter. So that song was rearranged with horns by Corbin Jones, actually. So yeah, one more round of applause, Mr. Corbin Jones. The first arrangement of that song, in that particular way, that of course was Mood Indigo by Duke Ellington. But that particular arrangement was done by none other than Nina Simone. She had a very cool arrangement of it, and we were really excited to sort of recreate it. Nina Simone is a very important person in our music, for our culture. But before she was the Nina Simone that we all know, she was playing a lot of jazz standards, like that one. And when she first arrived in New York in 1956, 1957, she got to New York. Her manager called a couple musicians to play with her. And one of those musicians was our bassist, Bill Crow. So Bill, I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit about meeting Nina and playing with Miss Simone for the first time.
Well, it was just another club date for me. The Paul Modian was the drummer, and we'd been called quite often to play with people like George Wallington and on the off nights at Birdland, that sort of thing. So this was the off night at the Embers over on the east side. And we'd never heard of Nina Simone before. We met her, and she told us a bunch of standards that she was going to do. And she had some music for one tune that she had prepared, I Love You, Porgy. And on that one, our ears picked up. We said, oh, there's a voice here and a conception that's quite unusual. The rest of it was just a regular job accompanying a singer. And about a year later, she recorded that tune, I Love You, Porgy, and it was a big hit, and it started her career, and you know where it went from there. So we were very, very proud to have given her her start in New York. I was thinking about other singers that I admired in those days, and one of them was Joe Turner. Now, he was from Kansas City originally. He was a bartender. He used to sing with the band from the bar, and he became a great blues singer. Lasted for many years. And the best album that I remember that he made was called Boss of the Blues. It's a beautiful album. And one of the tunes that I learned from him was Lowdown Dog. So I think we'll do that. So my rhythm section is about to give me an introduction. One, two, you know what to do. Well, I ain't gonna be your low-down dog no more. Ain't gonna be your low-down dog anymore. You don't want me, baby, down the road I go. Now I've worked hard and brought you home my pay. Yes, I worked hard, baby, brought you home my pay. You're certainly gonna miss me when I've gone away. I'm shouting, woo, woo-ee. Woo, woo-ee. It's a low-down shame the way you mistreat poor me. Play the blues.
Bill Crow. Bill Crow. Bill Crow and Corbin Jones playing double duty. Thank you so much. And I would like to also introduce on piano, Miss Angela Kent, everyone. On piano, Miss Angela Kent. As Nina grew and developed, she started to, as she said, reflect the times that she lived in. She believed that an artist must reflect the times that they live in. And this next song we're gonna do is certainly an example of that. And Brianna,
yes,
could you introduce this next song, please?
But of course. So as Jake was saying, Nina made clear to herself in her own spirit and to many of us as artists that she believed that it was an artist's duty to reflect what they believed in and to speak for society. And she was alive during the civil rights movement and seeing what was going on. She wrote many songs, Mississippi Goddamn, and she wrote this next song that is an anthem to black kids, black people everywhere. It says, to be young, gifted, and black. Yes.
Yeah.
Gabrielle Murphy, everybody. Gabrielle Murphy, come on. So, continuing on in this same realm, I would like to introduce Corbin Jones to introduce the next song. Corbin Jones, everybody.
This next song is by the Staple Singers, who got their start singing spirituals. And in the same way as spirituals, we're brought together by a common theme or hope, like music being the vehicle for bringing us together with the message of hope. They went on to sing protest songs, which are doing a similar thing, right? Instead of just saying a message, something that people need to hear, instead of just saying something where we're fighting for change and maybe people aren't listening, through the vehicle of music, you get people tapping their feet, you get people clapping along, and they're digesting a message that maybe they wouldn't have heard or maybe just wouldn't have been as widespread. So we're going to sing this next song, a protest song written about the March on Selma from Selma to Montgomery, Alabama. This is Freedom Highway by the Staple Singers, and Justin's going to start us off on the guitar.
Each and every day, made up my and every day, each and every day, each and every day, each and every day.
Norman Edwards. Norman Edwards. We have been lifted. At this point, we're going to give the band a little bit of a break, and we are going to invite some special guests up. So, band, thank you very much. I would like to introduce Justin Poindexter to introduce the Branchettes.
All right, it is my absolute pleasure to welcome one of my real heroes to the stage now. I grew up in North Carolina, and there's a band there that's been playing for almost 60 years called the Branchettes. They're from Newton Grove, North Carolina, and they're led by Mother Lena Mae Perry, and she's one of the most astounding artist and one of the most astounding people I've ever met. And it's a real pleasure for me to know her and to have learned from her, and I can't tell you what pleasure it brings to me to bring her to you today. This is the incredible The Branchettes featuring Mother Lena Mae Perry and Angela Kinn on the piano.
Banks of the river, oh Lord, and I there is Rome at the cross for you. Though millions have come, but there's still room for one. There is room at the cross for you. So I cherish the old rugged cross. Ooh, till my trophies at last I lay.
Do the last he touched me, because God has touched me today. Glory to God. When I come in here, my voice try to act up, so I couldn't sing. I'm gonna give God credit, because whatever it was, he moved it. Trying to sing now.
My soul.
too far from where I started from.
For Mother Perry. And Miss Angela. This next hymn that we're gonna sing for you together is one that is an old hymn, and it's one that's near and dear to our hearts. Martin Luther King, the night he was assassinated, knew that he was gonna die. And his final words were a request for this song. He said, "Play Precious Lord tonight and make it pretty." Mahalia Jackson, who is one of the greatest voices and spirits of all time, made this song famous, and it was an anthem of the civil rights movement and still an anthem for many today. An anthem of hope, asking for God to take our hands. It is my honor to sing it with Mother Perry. This is "Precious Lord, Take My Hand."
And when
another day is past and gone. Precious Lord,
precious
got a
Lord.
Testimony. Take my hand,
take my hand,
lead me on,
lead me on,
let me stand,
let me stand.
Sometimes I get tired,
times I get tired,
sometimes I'm weak,
sometimes I'm weak,
sometimes I'm old. Precious, precious Lord,
and leave
me on.
The Branchettes, everybody. The Branchettes. The Branchettes. Yeah. Lena Mae Perry. Please don't go anywhere. Angela Kent. Mother Lena Mae Perry. Brianna Thomas. So, we're gonna get the band back up here. And actually, I think we're gonna play our last song. And then, would you join us for the last song? Would it be all right if the Branchettes come back for the last song? This last song was also a favorite of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It was written by Dr. Billy Taylor. And Brianna, is there anything you want to say about this one?
Dr. Billy Taylor, famous, loved teacher, educator, jazz pianist, and composer. And Dr. Martin Luther King loved him as well. He used to invite him to join him at the marches and use his voice. In fact, he would invite him to sing and or to play that Baptist hymn that he wrote, as he would call it. And that Baptist hymn was, "I Wish I Knew How It Would Feel to Be Free." Thank you.
sweet it would be if I found I could fly.
Make some noise, the Branchettes, everybody, the Branchettes. Mother Lena Mae Perry, Angela Kent, Brianna Thomas, Bruce Harris, Alphonso Horne, Gabrielle Murphy, Corbin Jones, Norman Edwards, Bill Crow, Justin Poindexter, thank you very much. Thank you very much, we love you. Take care.
Jake Blasini.
Hey.